Assalamu alaikum, I am Asad Yusuf. Welcome to MPT channel. Today's topic is intensity modulated radiation therapy, that is IMRT. So these are the outlines of today's presentation. So if you can see the profile, here is a beam profile, a simple beam profile, open beam profile one could say, but if you insert a wedge, so intensity modulated in one direction, so it's may call one dimensional modulation. But if you use MLCs, which are two dimensional, and at that moment two banks moves, like A bank and a B bank and MLC, one is a forward direction, another is in reverse direction, and it can generate a modulated profile according to your requirement. So, introduction, aim to deliver radiation more precisely to the tumor while relatively limiting the dose to the surrounding normal tissue. The purpose of this presentation is to discuss the concept of IMRT and its comparison with other RT methods. Literature review, it started from 1950s when linac accelerator was marked for the treatment of cancer. 1980, 3D conformal radiotherapy was introduced and 3D CRT based on 3D dose planning systems conformed the shape of the radiation beam to that of the tumor. But the problem is, cannot conform well to the 3D object due to the uniformity of the beam strength. So the 30% of the tumor exhibit concave features, so very difficult with the conventional conformer RT. So in 1960s, IMRT was first conceptualized. In 1994, the first commercial IMRT delivery unit was introduced. IMRT, an advanced form of 3D CRT, based on linear accelerator. Today we do have some our modalities like tomotherapy, halcyon, all those technologies use IMRT or advanced IMRT like a VMAT. So where the radiation intensity could be modulated during treatment, the field is geometrically shaped by MLCs. The intensity is varied pixel by pixel within a shape field. And these are some images. And you can see the concavity was never achieved in 3D CRT, whereas an MRT can easily conform the dose with the tumor. So the physical aspect, IMRT combined two advanced concepts to deliver the 3D CRT. The one is inverse treatment planning with the help of optimization by computer, and a computer controlled intensity modulation of the radiation beam during the treatment, that is with the MLC. Inverse planning method are divided into two, analytic method and iterative method. This is an old method, it's now not in use, whereas iterative method still you'll find in most of the planning systems. So an iterative method, it could use a deterministic model. There are two types of deterministic models, simplex type or gradient-based stiffened descent. Still are very old versions before 16 used gradient-based method for the IMRT. Many computer programs use both methods to achieve beam arrangement. Analytical method, it's a mathematical technique in which the target volume dose distribution depend on the point dose intensity. Whereas iterative method, it's a manual technique and the beamlet depend on the cost function, that is the energy dose for each point in target volume. So if you take the example of gradient-based method, there are two phases. One is gradient direction, the other is gradient length. So it started with this point and try to achieve the minima. So the idea is that it will achieve a global minima, but it could be trapped in local minima. So forward planning, we set the field, we set the weightage, shielding, and we get the result. Whereas, so is how it works, and this is the flow of the power planning. Features of power planning is empirical approach, predictable isodose line, limited flexibility, difficult when targeting compass the OAR. So this is a simple Fluence map. Whereas the inverse planning, you do have a target volume, but the fields, yes, we have to define the field, but there are options that helps you to define the fields, the beam angle optimizer. In Eclipse, I'm not aware of the Electa unit. Then it'll give you the cost function, the priorities, and this how it will try to achieve what you have given. This is a simple workflow of IMRT. So it can be mapped with the grids like open fields, polar one, dynamic wedge. You can see the starting is the hard one is one. The intensity is higher in the middle region and the very lower, optimal, lower and higher. This is how it works. Whereas a block, shields, for example, these corners will guide the zero, whereas the open area is one. But a 2D compensator, you can easily mold according to the body. And this is what IMRT also works. So you ask what number will appear in that beamlet. The planner has to specify the number orientation of the open field. Number varies from 5 to 9 to even 13. Define objectives for the target and the computer will work for you. So one has to be aware about the constants versus object. The objective of the goals that has a clinical basis. Example, maximum dose of spinal cord is 45 or 46, whatever your clinician is aimed for. Whereas the constant are used to achieve these objectives. So it could vary. And it varies planner to planner. So the optimization object, input data optimize. No dose over 40 gray, for example, will put and that will result around 45 or maybe less. So extra constraint to shape the DVH do not necessarily reflect the clinical goals. So this is how the optimization works. These are blanks right now. Achieve the constraint and you'll get the result. If it doesn't achieve your desired results, then of course iteration will go on. And once it's done, it will be delivered with MLC. So what is the better treatment plan? The need to measure how far the objectives are achieved, state objective in mathematical functions, then measure the value of the gradient. If the O object function reaches a minimum, indicate a good plan has been achieved. And this is how it works. The sky coming down. And it could trap in these portions. And this is what happened in IMRT. Whereas in VMAT, it tried to jump by himself. But in IMRT, you have to change the constraint in order to get a good, in order to get your desired result. So the gradient method has this limitation that it usually trapped in local minima instead of global minima. And if you talk about the formula, the target, this is what it looks like. So the objectives, the weightage, the dose we intend for, minus the dose came at that pixel, minus the dose which we intend for in the whole square. And this is an object. And this is for the critical organ. So in IMRT or VMAT, there are two concepts, soft constraint and hard constraint. So the soft constraint also applied to the target as well to prevent the over or underdose the target, set the inhomogeneity within the target, more clinically relevant and realistic. And this is a difference. This is a heavy plant. You can see the curve, and this is a lower, slightly loose plant. The shoulder is high. And this is a lower soft constraint. You can see the inhomogeneity, high inhomogeneity is there. There is a hard constraint absolutely not to be violated under any circumstances. Limit dose to serial structure like chord. Essentially define allowable solution space. So this is how it looks like. How to modulate the intensity? So there are two methods, compensator or MLCs, or maybe other different machines. So optimal versus actual. So you have an optimizer, so-called PO, or old version have a different name. So planning optimizer give you an optimal result, but then it was calculated with the MLC, so the actual is may different from the optimal. And this is how it works, like using the MLC. So different MLC modes, step and shoot, slit beam steps across the field, beam on, the wireless leaves are stationary, beam off, the leaves are stepping across. A sliding window, slit beam swept across the field at various speed, generate the required fluence distribution, beam on, the leaves are moving. So this is a step and shoot, try to achieve different segments, and beam on and beam off conditions. Whereas in sliding window, it always on, but MLC is also moving, so it gives you similar result with the same segment. And this is another visual example of how the fluence are generated, how the MLCs are moving from one end to the other end. So by varying the swept type, the leaf gap, leaf speed, dose rate, all are very important to consider, and also for the quality assurance, these need to be considered. There are FWPM guidelines available for the MLC QA, all going along the line for the particular leaf pair in a 1D profile, and fluence for this leaf pair and the flame. And this is 1D profile converted into 2D profile. So this is an example of how the delivery was done. The control point started with 1 and with 150, and the dose fraction was delivered during this process. Thank you very much for listening, and remember, this is how the radiation deposited in almost any pattern. Thank you for your time.